If you are a swimmer, then you must be knowing that when you go for a swim in a lake or in a pool, you don't need any special kind of suit apart from your swimming apparel. And that is true for any swimmer. Any swimmer who goes for a swim in a pool or a lake or even a pond will not need any special kind of suit. However, in this picture you can see that this man is wearing a suit which looks kind of heavy and quite elaborate. This man is a deep sea diver. That is, unlike swimmers who swim at shallow depths or roughly on the surface of the water, deep sea divers have to go deep beneath the surface of water. That is at great depths of almost around 500, 600, 700 meters below sea level. So in that case, these deep sea divers have to wear special suits. But why is it that for a swimmer who is swimming at a shallow depth, he does not need a special suit or she does not need a special suit, but for a deep sea diver, they need special suits? Let us find out through the application of science. Now over here we have considered a vertical liquid column that has a cross-sectional area of A, that is this area. The cross-sectional area of this liquid column is A and it has a height h. Now since this is a liquid column having a specific area and height, it occupies a certain amount of space. So this liquid column will be exerting an amount of force at its bottom. And since this bottom has an area, we can also say that there will be pressure at the bottom of the liquid column. So let us find out how we can calculate the pressure at the bottom of the liquid column. So firstly, we write the expression for pressure at the bottom of a liquid column. The pressure will be force divided by area. That is force per unit area. And here we have taken a consideration that the liquid column is at rest. Now this is the assumption with which we are moving forward. So when the liquid column is at rest, the force that will be applied by the liquid column at its bottom will be equal to the weight of the liquid column. And how can we find out the weight of the liquid column? Simply by multiplying its mass by the acceleration due to gravity, that is represented by g. Thus, weight of the liquid column will be given by mass of the liquid column into g, that is the acceleration due to gravity. Now, if you recall from our previous lecture, we have seen that density rho is equal to mass per unit volume. That is mathematically equal to mass divided by volume. So if I rearrange this equation, I will be able to write rho into volume is equal to mass. So I can replace this rho into volume equals to mass in this particular equation. So firstly, I have written mass is equal to volume into density, that is rho. Now once I replace this expression into this expression, what do I get? I get the force exerted at the bottom that is equal to the weight of the liquid column as equal to volume of the liquid column into density of the liquid column into g. That is volume into density into acceleration due to gravity. Now the volume of the liquid column can be very easily found out. How? We have been given the area of cross section, that is A, and we know the height that is also given to us, which is h. So the volume will be nothing but the area of cross section times the height given, that is A into h. So now I can replace this value A into h in this expression in place of volume. So what do I get? If I replace the volume of liquid column in that expression, I will get the force exerted at the bottom as equal to A into h into rho into g. That is area of cross section into height of the liquid column into the density of the liquid column into acceleration due to gravity. So now how will I be able to find out the pressure at the bottom of the liquid column? The pressure will be nothing but the force exerted, that is AH rho g, divided by the area on which this force is exerted, that is A. So since A is common, I can cancel it out. Thus, I can say that since pressure at the bottom of the liquid column is equal to force divided by area, I will get AH rho g divided by A. And on cancelling out A from the numerator as well as denominator, I am left with H rho g. Thus, pressure at the bottom of a liquid column is given by its density times acceleration due to gravity times the height of the liquid column from the top of the liquid column, or in other words, the depth of the liquid column. So if we consider this equation, we can find that the pressure at any point on the liquid is dependent on its height from the top and its density, provided that g remains constant, which it will if we are on the surface of the earth. So assuming g to be constant, these are the two factors that pressure exerted by the liquid column is dependent on. So now let us consider what happens when a swimmer swims in water. Now the body of the swimmer is roughly at a depth of 1 meter from the top. Or in other words, we can say that the height of the swimmer from the top of the liquid is 1 meter. So height from the surface of the water is 1 meter. Now we consider a vertical column of liquid directly above the swimmer. Now since this is a water column, it will have molecules or water molecules which will exert their weight upon the swimmer. So since these molecules have a certain amount of mass and they are pulled by gravity, they will be exerting their weight on the swimmer. And this weight per unit area will be the pressure exerted on the swimmer. So how can we find out the pressure exerted on the swimmer? We apply the formula that we had obtained, that is density into height into acceleration due to gravity. The density of water is rho. We have considered that the height of the swimmer from the top or the surface of the water is 1 meter and acceleration due to gravity is g. So the pressure exerted on the body of the swimmer by this liquid column is equal to rho g. Now let us consider the case for the deep sea diver. Now the deep sea diver has or is swimming at a depth of 600 meters below water. Or in other words, we can say the deep sea diver lies around 600 meters below water level. So thus the height from the surface of the water for the deep sea diver is 600 meters. Now again in the case of the deep sea diver, he will have a long column of water molecules above him, that is a long liquid column. Now since this liquid column will have water molecules which will be exerting their weight on the swimmer, these molecules will also apply a pressure on the body of the swimmer, because these molecules have an amount of mass and they are attracted by the force of gravity. So thus they will be exerting their pressure, that is force per unit area, on the body of the deep sea diver. So let us now calculate what the pressure on the body of the deep sea diver will be. The pressure on the body of the deep sea diver can be found out from the same relation, that is rho into h into g. So over here h is 600 meters, that is the distance of the deep sea diver from the top or the surface of the water. So we get rho into 600 into g, which is equal to 600 rho g. So we found out that the pressure exerted on the swimmer is rho into g, whereas the pressure exerted on the deep sea diver is 600 rho g by the liquid column above their bodies. So thus, as you can clearly see, the pressure exerted on the deep sea diver is 600 times the pressure exerted on the swimmer. And it is due to this extreme high pressure that deep sea divers require a specialized suit. These specialized suits or diving suits are designed so as to counterbalance the extreme pressure that is exerted by water on the deep sea diver. And these suits ensure that the deep sea diver does not get crushed once they go inside water. So now consider these four vessels that have different shapes. Now in all these four vessels, the same liquid has been added. Let us say water. Now my question to you is, at which point A, B, C or D will pressure be maximum? And at which point will it be minimum? You will be surprised to find that pressure will be the same at A, B, C and D. Why? Because as I mentioned, firstly, we are adding water in all the vessels. Now, if you observe closely, you will find that the height of water in all of them are the same. So initially, we are not considering the height. Let's say we don't consider height for a while and we consider rho and g. Now, since rho is same, that is density is same for all the liquids because it is water, and g is also same, that is the acceleration due to gravity is constant, the pressure exerted at points A, B, C, D will depend only on height. And since height is the same, we can say that the pressure at points A, B, C and D will also be the same, because height of the liquid column is same in all the cases. Now take a look at a very interesting video. In this video, there is a water bottle which is punctured at 5 points. Now if you observe closely, these 5 points are punctured, and from all these 5 points, water is coming out. If you look, then you will find that at the topmost point, water is coming out but not traveling a very long distance. Or in other words, it has less velocity. As we move down from the top of the bottle, we find that as height from the top of the water increases, the velocity with which water is coming out is increasing. Or in other words, water coming out is moving a greater length. This is because pressure is increasing as you are moving from top to bottom. And it is due to this increase in pressure that the liquid from the bottom is flowing to a maximum range as compared to the liquid from the top. Now take a look at another interesting video. Over here you will find four vessels of different shapes attached by a horizontal tube, and a liquid is poured from one of the vessels. Now the moment it is done so, you will find that the liquid takes up the same level in all of them. This is because the pressure at the bottom has to be the same, and since it is the same liquid rho and acceleration due to gravity g is constant, h will also have to be the same, because pressure at their bottoms will have to be the same and the pressure will be dependent on height. So if pressure has to be the same, the height of the liquid will also have to be the same. So regardless of the shape of the vessel, whenever liquid is poured into any one of the vessels, it seeks out its own height in all the vessels, which is the same for each and every vessel. And thus we can say that liquid seeks its own level.